Hello everyone, I'm Marty Pospisil from Pospisil Realty Group and welcome to the November Market Update. We're going to launch right into things. We're going to talk about the sales activity in Vancouver. And just before we do that, I want to touch on the sales ratio, which is the metric that I use to determine how active the market is. The sales ratio, very simply, is the absorption rate of product on a monthly basis. So if we take the total sales for the month divided by the number of active listings, we get the percent of homes selling or the absorption rate. If that rate is below 11%, we're in a buyer's market and there's downward pressure on pricing. If we're between 12 and 20%, we're in a balanced market. It's not favoring the buyers or the sellers. But if the sales ratio is greater than 21%, we are in what we call a seller's market, and there's upwards pressure in prices. So the balance is what determines the price fluctuations. Let's get right into our market speedo and see how the market is bearing today as of the stats from the end of October. Basically, we expect home sales to continue the momentum we're seeing to 2021. Due to the increasing activity in the economy and the low interest rates. We're currently at a 25% sales ratio for Vancouver, an extremely active seller's market. So let's look at some finer numbers here. We're looking year over year. Total listings are up to 7,173 from last year. Total sales are up year over year from last year. And the total pricing is up 10% year over year from this time last year. So looking at some more exact numbers, I put this table together for us to help us really see what's happening. Sales activity year over year, detached houses, Metro Vancouver are up 42.3%. So the activity of sales, not pricing, but the activity is up 42% for houses. 46% for attached townhomes and duplexes, and 13.5% for condos. And the benchmark pricing year over year for houses up 8.9% since last year, this time last year. For townhomes, half duplexes, 5.4%, and for condos, year over year, we're up 4.4%. And very importantly, since last month, which is why I boxed this, houses have come up 1.1%. Attached townhomes and half duplexes, just 0.4%, almost 0.5%. No change in apartments. Why is our market so hot? Again, same reasons, high demand for more space. Homeowners are seriously rethinking their housing needs due to the pandemic, so there is a demand for more space. And steady inventory levels. There is no mad rush of inventory coming onto the market. So the people who are making these moves are doing it cautiously, slowly. They're planning it out. There's no panic in the market, and that's keeping the inventory level steady. Even lower interest rates than my last update last month. We're seeing five-year mortgages at 1.7%. It's crazy. Three-year variables, even lower than that. So what a great time for home buyers and existing homeowners to be getting mortgages. And of course, our recovering economy doing better and better as we go month by month. The unemployment rate, you can see, has decreased substantially and is continuing to do so. We're looking at our market activity with home sales, new listings, and housing starts. The listings are, of course, increasing, not as much as the sales. But the sales are increased dramatically. Housing starts are puttering along, but well in line with the COVID baseline that we're seeing. Our anticipated economic recovery, again, thanks to the stats from BCREA, are continuing to recover. Our economies continue to recover at a dramatic rate. We're expecting next year for that to ease off a little bit, but continue in that same trend. So all good news from an economic point of view. And the MLS home sales forecast for next year are to be even higher than what we're seeing this year. So it looks like a lot of good news is coming our way. We're seeing the forecast for this activity to continue and next year to be even more sales. We're experiencing this now as well with our new virtual platform and our revised pandemic marketing plan that we started back in March. We're getting incredible results. One of the things we're doing new is our live stream broadcasts. And look at these numbers. Here's a home we just sold this week. We generated 20 offers, and our sellers were able to achieve a sale price $430,000 above asking. That's incredible results. But here's why. We had 2,100 people watch that live stream video on Facebook that we posted. So just amazing response rate from that online social virtual platform that improves the safety and the comfort for the buying experience and keeps our sellers safe. Can share more of that with you on another time. There's us holding the offers this week. There's another one we did this week. Really, really incredible activity in our market. So what's hot and what's not? Again, keeping in mind our sales ratio numbers, less than 11%, buyer's market 12-20, balanced market and over 21%, seller's market upward pressure. How are we doing in all the fronts? So for Metro Vancouver, detached houses, we're at 20%. So we're right in that transitional line from balanced to seller's market. So detached houses doing very well compared to 18% last month. We've got an increase in activity in our houses on the west side. Condos and townhomes, very heated 25% seller's market, up from 23% last month. And again, you can freeze the video at any time, see the different price bands, the different neighborhoods, and see the sales ratio for all of those neighborhoods for condos and townhomes. And then, of course, the east side, how's that faring? We still have a super overheated market on the east side for houses at 30%. And that's a little bit down from last month at 33%. So we might have seen that cresting already take place in houses on the east side. And then east side count, condos and townhomes, we're at 29%. Again, still extremely, extremely active sellers market, multiple offers, higher than list sales if they're being marketed properly. And that is slightly down from last month's 33%. So again, we may have seen the east side crest a little bit last month. Overall, Metro Vancouver, we're seeing all three product in townhomes, condos, detached, in that seller's market band for the sales ratio. So very, very good activity. What's happening in the burbs? Well, you can see from a monthly variance from last month, the previous month, we've got increased activity for detached on the west side, same as North Vancouver, a little bit down in Burnaby and the east side as we just saw, and out in the burbs, we're seeing some decrease in activity. Further out in the Fraser Valley, we're seeing increased activity in houses. So it's really spotty market on the detached front. Attached monthly variance from the previous month, we're seeing increased activity, of course, in the west side. Burnaby is the same. And most of the burbs are increased activity in the attached product month over month. What next? Where is this market going next? That's the $1 trillion question. We graph activity month to month, year over year. This is kind of interesting. If you look at the last many years we've graphed, 2016, 17, 18, 19, you see a general trend of activity into spring. It drops down in summer, and then we get another burst of activity in fall. But here's 2020. Here's how the year started out. Increased activity, boom, March 15th, phase one shutdown. Activity dropped down, and then we had a gradual increase in activity, little bit of a plateau in July, and then an increase in activity again. So this market is anything but normal from the previous cycles that we see typically annually. Not surprising. Brendan Ogmanson from the BCREA sums it up perfectly. I couldn't say it better myself. Well, the pent-up demand may be starting to fade. Record low interest rates, a recovering job market are supporting strong sales. A pandemic-driven shift in buyers' preference for extra space is pushing those prices upward. And you can see the activity here shooting right up. But those are our main factors. consumers are rethinking housing. And that's the underlying deep motivation that they're getting, being facilitated with the low interest rates, the steady inventory, et cetera, driving our market today. But the underlying factor is consumers want more space. That's the November 2020 market update. I'm Marty Pospisil. Stay safe, and we'll see you in a month.